Edie was honored at the Emmys this last year, and the ensemble was honored at the SAGs just this last week. But it's in the comedy category, and there's so much more than it being a comedic series. What do you think is going to happen with these categories? It's a bit confusing.
I think that the categories as we know them are becoming a little bit amorphous, because it used to be, for example, the hour-longs were straight-up dramas, and now you've got things like Glee and Desperate Housewives, and Glee's now in the comedy, Desperate Housewives is in the comedy. We don't have any real half-hour dramas. I don't think that we're not a comedy. I think we're a very specific kind of comedy. I think our comedy is born out of gallows humor, and if you're going to pull off gallows humors, there's going to be gallows, and gallows are dramatic.
And similarly, I mean, like maybe Men of a Certain Age is kind of, you know, what is that, a drama? Is it a comedy? And Ray Romano and Mike Royce wrote it, so it must be a comedy. It's kind of a strange era we're entering.
But again, you know, isn't that's a 60-minute show, is it not? You know, it makes it really hard for them to say, well, we're a comedy, when they want to go into, you know, again, it's that sort of, if you're in an in-between tone, it doesn't mean that you're, that you don't have a tone. It means that you've got a very specific tone. And, you know, we're not, you know, pound for pound, we're never going to be as funny as 30 Rock or The Office or Modern Family, but that's not the kind of show we are. So when the shows are being nominated for performances or for writing, you hope that they're really being judged on the actor's performance and on the writer's ability to write, and not how funny it is. I know you're in a comedy, but it's not about what's the funniest. I mean, Laverne and Shirley is funnier than anything, but it doesn't mean that it's the best writing. It doesn't mean it's not. I'm just using that as an example. So you have to hope that people will be open to new ways of stories being told and new, you know, new platforms for comedy. I mean, it's grim comedy, but it's not comedy.
Well, I mean, Edie complained. I was in the press room. She's like, this is a bizarre honor. I'm not a comedic actress. But she has incredible timing. How did you write for her? I mean, what adjustments did you make to, like, you just mentioned with Merritt how you expanded the role. What did you do with Edie?
The most fun, the best part about working with Edie is that she's an actor who is who responds very truthfully to whatever circumstance her character is in. And so when you put an absurd or ridiculous or funny thing in front of her, she responds out of that world. So, you know, we're sort of, you know, Jackie will have, Edie has, as you said, she has astonishing, astonishing timing. And if everything around her is chaos and absurdity, she's in the middle of the chaos and absurdity and is able to ground it. And so we're never going to give her, you know, jokes or pratfalls or make her the center of the humor. She's just the center of the universe that a lot of humor and a lot of tragedy orbits around.
Well, it's been great watching, you know, the character arcs and where you're taking this kind of gang of misfits. And I can't wait to see the upcoming season.
You're going to like season 3.